Hello, all my joy friends, and welcome to Once Upon a Storybook. My name is Cynthia with Cynthia's Joyful Creations, and today we're going to look at another angel story from the book In the Arms of Angels by Joan Wester Anderson. And today's story is titled Helper on the Highway. But if these beings guard you, they do so because they have been summoned by your prayers. And this phrase is from St. Ambrose. Susan Clifford of Leland, Illinois, was diagnosed with diabetes when she was 10 years old. Her younger brother also had the disease. Millions live with this chronic and serious illness, Susan says. But my mom was a positive person, and she stressed each day that our lives could be worse. So I guess I regarded diabetes as a blessing of sorts because eventually it led me to my life's work. As a small child in Catholic school, Susan also learned about guardian angels, and later she named hers Hope. Hope was quite busy watching over a child with a chronic illness, but Susan thrived. Despite her condition, she became a registered nurse, married a police officer, and had three children. Life was hectic, but Susan managed to keep her diabetes under control. She used a home monitor to measure her blood sugar several times a day. That's important because morning insulin can reach its peak around late afternoon and sugar levels can drop if food is delayed or you are more active than usual. If levels do drop, there are signals that alert a diabetic that food or drink is immediately necessary. It's a delicate balancing act, but one that people learn to do. One sunny Sunday afternoon, Susan's teenage son, Matt, asked Susan for a ride to a friend's house. The Cliffords lived in a rural setting with curving roads lined with fields of corn and wheat. They felt that Matt needed more practice time behind the wheel before getting his license. Susan agreed to take him. They had just finished brunch, and since she would be in the car, she decided to go grocery shopping too. She quickly checked her blood sugar, and it was normal. She'd be home well before she needed food again. "I dropped Matt off and went into town to the supermarket," Susan recalls. "But shortly after I started shopping, something seemed odd. As she traveled the aisles, the environment seemed to be slowing all around her. It was taking me forever to choose each item. A faint cold sweat dampened her forehead despite the air conditioning, and she felt a bit dazed, confused. With the part of her brain that was still functioning normally, she sensed that her blood sugar might be low. Maybe a carton of juice would help. However, people whose blood sugar drops rapidly don't always process thought in the normal way," Susan says. "They may go on with what they're doing and delay treatment, which makes things worse. It's like a vicious cycle. This is what happened to Susan. Moving through the store in slow motion haze, she continued to shop for almost 2 hours. Although she had placed crackers and juice in her cart, it didn't occur to her to actually consume them. Confused, I paid for my many groceries, loaded them into the station wagon, got in, and finally downed the crackers and juice. Within minutes, I began to feel like myself." Susan was stunned to discover how much time had passed. Her husband would be worried. She let a few moments pass just to make sure she was fine, then pulled out of the parking lot and onto the highway. "I left the front windows open, and after a few moments, I reached into my purse for my rosary," Susan recalls. As a busy mother, she often prayed or talked to Hope while in the car. She was on the first decade of the rosary when she began to feel drowsy. A dreamlike lethargy came over her as she wound around a curve, followed by darkness. How peaceful it all seemed. Were her eyes closed? She didn't know. She didn't care. It was quiet here. Quiet and safe. Vaguely, she heard the sound of tires driving over gravel, but they couldn't be her tires. She didn't seem to be in a car at all. She was floating in space, drifting with nothing around her but this warm, pervading dark. How long was Susan apparently unconscious? No one will ever know. But her next moment of awareness didn't come until she approached a three-way stop sign in her town, at an intersection not on her normal route. An intersection some 12 miles from where she had slipped into sleep. She was holding the steering wheel, her rosary in her lap, but she was not yet coherent. "I drove past my own house twice before finally pulling into the driveway," she says. Susan ran into the kitchen where her concerned husband recognized her dazed condition, took a blood check, and gave her some food. Only hours later did she feel well enough to consider what had happened. Had Susan actually driven that winding 12-mile stretch at 55 miles per hour with her eyes closed? Or had someone else taken over for her, preventing her from causing a terrible accident for herself and others? It had to be hope, Susan finally decided. Who else could have seen, steered, accelerated, and braked the station wagon but her guardian angel? Later, when I drove that route back and forth, I was in awe of the usual high-speed traffic, turns, curves, farm equipment in the road, stop signs, concrete abutments, and children playing, Susan says. Once I even closed my eyes for a few seconds, and that affirmed my belief that hope had been in charge. I was left shivering in terror and spilling tears of joy. Susan believes that she should have followed up the crackers and juice with heavier food before taking to the road. Today she wears an insulin pump, and in her work as a diabetes educator at a nearby hospital, she also trains others with diabetes to use pumps. She shares her own experience as an example of how cautious her patients must be before driving, encouraging them to always check their blood sugar first. Susan also gives thanks to God for Hope, her life companion. She is a daily reminder of my faith and the hope that God provides us every day. Angels bring God close to us all. No wonder we love them so much. Well, thank you for joining me for this angel story called Helper on the Highway. I hope you enjoyed it, and I look forward to another angel story with you next week. This has been Once Upon a Storybook with Cynthia, and I will see you in the next video with another angel story. Bye, everyone.